Okay, hello guys. We have here a new movie of nerdiasm about a new telephone. No, seriously guys, this is something to get excited about. This is my very old phone. I use it at the moment because the one I used the last 1.5 years is the VK World 6735. And this is one of the most cheap phones that you can find, but it has two SIM slots and an SD card. It has everything besides gyroscope. But this was a great phone for the price. I paid like 70 euros for it, like $80, let's say. And it took okay pictures. It wasn't great, but it has a great Wi-Fi. This phone played thousands of hours of YouTube. I wish I could turn it on again. I want to have a couple of pieces of it, but yeah, it's done. This one is like, I don't know, I think 7 or 8 years old. It's a Windows phone. It's one of the best phones. It never is reformatted. It's still the same operating system. It's still working like a charm. It's great. It's just working every single time. It does what it needs to do. I don't know what people have against those Windows phones. They're awesome. No, seriously, they're awesome. I can't believe that they didn't break through compared to Android. Android is, it's compared to the Windows 7 phones, it's total garbage. You have phone calls, address book, SMS, mail, your internet. You only need those icons. If you have your settings, the first page is all your phone settings. And then the second page, and that's all, you have two pages of settings, is for all your applications, like Internet Explorer, your games, your messaging, Office and stuff. And the first is just the Wi-Fi. It's so easy. That's everything you need to know. For elderly people, this is the best phone in the world. Can't believe that this didn't break through. It never crashes. It never crashes. It's still working. It's still the same battery, 8 years old battery. It didn't hiccup once. But now, my boss said, get yourself a new phone. He threw a bundle of cash to me. So I got myself a new phone and I wanted a big battery. And this is the phone with the biggest battery on the planet at the moment. This is a 5,100 milliamp hour battery. The Lenovo P2. Lenovo, that's the previous IBM. And this is actually a Motorola phone. Lenovo bought Motorola. And Motorola makes great phones, really, seriously. Do you want some information? I give you some information. It has an octa-core 2 GHz ARM Cortex A53 processor. It's an Adreno 506 GPU at 550 MHz. This one has 4 GB of RAM. You have a version with 3 GB of RAM. This is just a 32 GB of storage. You have a 64, but yeah, I couldn't get it fast enough. You can expand it with micro SD cards. You only have 2 slots, or you have 2 SIMs, or you have 1 SIM and 1 SD card. 5,100 milliamp battery, the biggest on the planet in a phone. 5.5 inch full HD, nothing fancy, full HD super AMOLED Gorilla Glass display. The rear camera is a 30 megapixel Sony 258 sensor with a 2-stop aperture. It has an autofocus, dual LED, dual tone flash, and it's capable of HDR. The front camera is only a 5 megapixel fixed focus, f-stop of 2.2. A single speaker, but it has 2 microphones. So, and it's micro USB, and it has a headset jack, a 3.5 millimeter one. I'm gonna leave it at that and just open this box. It's burning in my pocket for a while now. Oh, and it has a fingerprint scanner and you can NFC charge another phone with this. Let's open it up. Da-da-da-da. Let's open this phone box. It's airtight. So, it's a little bit bigger phone as my previous one, but not by much. Whoa. It feels cold. It's really metal. Yeah, and I took the gold one, the gray one or the black one. The gray one was €39 more expensive, so like $45. The other downside of this was that the battery is not interchangeable or not removable. So the VK World is 136 grams. My old Samsung. Let's do it without the protector. 138 grams. So only 2 grams more heavy. And it has a fully charged battery. Okay, and this is the Lenovo. 180. Yeah, it felt a little bit more heavy. So that's 44 grams more heavy. All the buttons are the same as my old one. The volume buttons and the on and off switch. And then you have the home button, a distance sensor and the camera, or vice versa. And then two facing speakers, which is only one, but it's probably channeled to those two holes. Let's check what else is in the box. SIM tool guides. What is this? Oh, that's probably to charge. You can use the cell phone as a power bank, and then you have a normal USB outlet. So this is a fast charger, which is quite a big brick. 12 volt 2 amp, 24 watts. Oh. Okay, you just need to press it. Oh, that's for a nano. I don't have a nano. Oh, you can make this one a nano. Cool. I can use all my SIMs without calling for a new one. This one is charging. It starts at 1%. They kind of shipped it really low. Normally, if you ship a LiPo, it needs to be at a certain percentage. Let's fire it up. It's getting quite warm though, because it's now maybe charging for 5 minutes and it's at 20%. The charger itself is getting really warm. Whoa! Lenovo, United States. Start. And there we go. Nice and fast. So this is a safe button. Ultimate power saver. So we have 30% battery. Probably can't read it. And I have 26 hours left. I can still phone, scroll my contacts and SMSs. I can add stuff. A calculator, calendar. Let's turn it off again. Is there a system update? Oh, there is a system update of 2 GB. I'm gonna do that later. I'm still installing apps. Because now I'm at Android 6. And I think there is an update for the 7. Let's take a picture. Snap it, Supper View. Let's take a picture of Morty. Oh, you can easily have your finger in front of the camera. It's a little bit of a shame. That's pretty fast. It looks nice. I don't know if it's gonna look nice on the file though. It looks nice. I don't know if it's gonna look nice. So yeah, I kind of like it. Okay, because I need 2 nano SIMs, and this is a micro SIM, I downloaded this paper. Okay, I'm gonna make a different movie about this. Okay, because I have a new phone, and my previous phone could have a nano SIM and a micro SIM. But now, I only can house 2 nanoseams. So I need to cut this up. You can print out this paper, which I'm gonna link a link in the descriptions. So we need to lay this down as good as we can. The top and the side. And then tape it down. Like so, I guess. And now we need a little stift, which should write on this plastic. Now I'm gonna do it with a scissor, but you can do it with a knife. Don't forget to take off the tape, because you can't really see it, but it's not gonna work with the tape on it. It doesn't make contact. Don't forget to remove that. I cut it a little bit small. Doesn't really matter that much. So the SIM cards work. I'm gonna close off this video. I like this phone up to now, because yeah, I'm coming from a phone 5 times less the price. It's a little bit bigger. I kind of like this one better in size. This one was the best, because yeah, it's really small. I hope I see you guys later in the next movie. Bye. Maybe something from 3D printing. This one is gonna be really cool if you're into 3D printing. This is surface coating liquid. I don't know what it's gonna do. I'm gonna try it. Last time I made a movie about the cheapest earphones in the world. I found even more cheap earphones. Bye! I ordered some goodies to go with this phone. A flexi case. SD card, tempered glass protector, charger, and a fast charger.